when I'm alone with only dreams of you that won't come true, what'll I do?
See that lift set up older again?
Bloody flats. I'd go on rent strike if I weren't already 7 months in arrears.
Start there or something.
I see you tidied up then.
I've been waiting for my trousers. You took your bloody time, didn't you?
Oh, I could hardly drag myself away. It was so romantic watching your jeans wrapping themselves around my knickers. It took me right back to when a quick tumble meant more than 20p's worth of hot air.
Hot air? You could talk about hot air. Next time Richard Branson feels like crossing the Atlantic in that giant Virgin Johnny of his, he could come round here, you could talk him up.
Right. Do you want to lift to your sisters, or are you going to stay here nagging the wallpaper off the wall?
Hang on, I just did my face.
I can't wait that long. My tax disc expires at Christmas.
There was 30 quid in here when I went up the laundrette.
No. Some thieving Turk must have had that away while you were adding a fabric conditioner.
I didn't take me purse up to the laundrette, you lying merchant. Well, that's my shopping money. I weren't bloody half of that, you thieving ponce. Do you know how many customers I had to shortchange to scrape that 30 quid together? You're going to put it on one of your three-legged horses, was you?
What I do with my money is down to me.
Your money? You parasite. You're supposed to be the breadwinner here. Instead, you're nicking the crumbs off my plate. What sort of husband are you?
Don't start all that. At least I didn't marry you under false pretenses.
Meaning what?
You know.
Say it.
What's the point?
Go on, say it.
All right. If I'd known you couldn't have kids...
Oh, you bastard.
Oh! You told me to say it. You're bloody mental.
Hang on, what about me lift?
Oi, get up.
What happened to the BMW?
Swapped it.
Through what? Exchanging Pratt? Look at the state of this. There's more dogs on this floor than Dan Battersea. No, I'm a bit untidy.
Like the Atlantic Ocean's a bit wide.
Look!
Last time I'll get you a romantic little surprise.
You've had a bird in here, haven't you?
Leave it out. I only picked it up last night. The car, I mean.
Well, you've got to be doing it with someone. Cos we ain't had it since Christmas. Then you kept calling me Sonia, you were so pissed.
Why? It's not doing.
But then why should I expect any different? You're a lousy provider. Why should you be any better in bed?
I might be if you lost a couple of stone. You could make a start by cutting your tongue out.
If only I'd married someone like Daryl. My sister wants for nothing. $750,000 that new house cost. Indoor pool. Her swimming costume costs more than my entire wardrobe.
And your swimming costume is bigger than her entire wardrobe. is at the time. They'll be off in a minute.
Chris, watch out!
What? What? Oh! I can see in the mirror.
You've got to go back and give your insurance company number.
What insurance?
What time is it, Trace?
To your new gold and platinum Rolex diver's watch, as worn by Seve Ballesteros, Frederick Forsyth, and Kerry Takanawa.
Stopped.
What? That's a 5 grand watch.
No, it ain't. It's a 50 quid copy I bought off Chris.
Oh, you ought to know by now his moody stuff's always rubbish.
I know, but he was a bit short and he won't take a handout.
We are talking about the same Chris here. What my sister sees in him.
Yeah, well. So what time is it anyway?
It's nearly 1 o'clock. That's assuming this watch you got me for my birthday is a real Cartier.
As if I'd have a stint when it comes to you, babe. Look at our palace. The pool. The cars. All for you and Garthy. Why do you think I work all the hours God sends?
Oh, I know. I'm really lucky to have you.
You haven't yet. But I think I can squeeze you in.
Oh, you're aware.
You can warm me up.
Not here.
Why not? No one can see us. We're detached now.
There is one thing I'd really like.
Me too, but I'm not making much progress.
A 6-week Far Eastern Paradise cruise calling at Bali, Bangkok, Hong Kong, Singapore, Bora Bora and Sydney.
Dunno. Don't really fancy all that Bora Bora nosh.
No.
Nah, it's a great idea, a cruise. After all, it's a week since we went on that safari.
So shall I book it?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, I really love you.
Come on, then. One for the road. Stuff me! It's the first time your brother-in-law's been on time in his life.
What a gorgeous ass.
A bit flash.
That's rich. Coming from the owner of a white Zephyr with tiger skin seats and more aerials on it than the Russian embassy. Oh, they've changed their cars again too. Mustn't half a wrecked a lot of conservatories. You want to get him to take you on full time?
I've got my own business.
Oh, yeah. Self-employed minicab driver and walking bookie's Christmas bonus.
Get out of bed, did we?
We was poolside.
Oh, pardon me for breathing.
She might. I won't. It's beautiful, Trace. It's like something at Santa Barbara.
Well, you can come in, you know. There's no charge on a weekday.
A type regarded tour. We've got to be a Newport Pagnell one.
Well, don't be late home, cos I've got your nice fillet steak for your tea.
You take your time, Daryl. I'll make sure your steak goes to a good home.
She's been living in a dream. She's been living in her car. She's been living in a plastic bubble. She's been living way beneath what she thought her life would be by now.
Oh, oh yes, and Whip's Cross was big.
It was all right for a semi, but we was overlooked by the neighbours.
Better than being overlooked by the council. I ain't had hot water for 3 weeks.
Well, maybe if you paid your rent.
Oh, don't you start. You forget what a struggle life is for Chris and me. I mean, it's all right for Daryl, isn't it? He's got a booming business. 6 erectors and a full-time accountant. But what does Chris earn?
I don't know. What does he earn? Feet?
Sorry. Search me. Be easier to find out the Pope's inside leg measurement. Then when he does have money, he spends it on sick animals. I suppose you could get Daryl to take him on full-time, could you?
Oh, no, Shaw. I never interfere in Daryl's business. But I know he don't need no full-time drivers. Only when he goes on these long hauls. Oh. Anyway, it's enough of the boys. This is girls' day out. Got some lovely leather trousers in at Skinner Romford.
I can't afford leather trousers. My purse is plastic. And it's empty.
That curse, I nicked me spending money.
Again? Here, treat yourself.
No.
Go on. No. It's only 50 quid. Go on.
I don't like to take charity, Tracy. I've got my principles.
Hello, my name's Dorian Green. I live next door. Can you help me? I'm in the middle of a terrible crisis. So, I came back from shopping to find the entire ground floor under 3 inches of foam.
What, you've had the fire brigade round?
No, the carpet cleaners came a day early and the stupid au pair let them in. I told Marcus we shouldn't have a German, but he said live and let live. I had all the girls coming over for coffee this afternoon. What am I going to do? I can't make them all sit in the kitchen.
Of course not. Bet it's hardly bigger than a tennis court, eh?
I've got a kettle on, Shao.
I'm not one to interfere. And God knows, cleaners are hard to find. But if mine spoke to me like that...
Sharon's my sister.
Really? You've decorated beautifully.
Thank you.
Oh, is this your son?
Garth. He's away at Fisk's.
It's a public school. Oh, public school.
Well, we want him to learn to talk proper.
Naturally. So, how are you settling in our exclusive little enclave?
You what?
Ryan Close.
Oh, you mean round here? Oh, it's lovely. Bit quiet, mind.
Yes. People do keep themselves to themselves. I've just had the most wonderful idea. I was going to have a little get-together for a few friends later, before the disaster with the deep pile. What are you up to this afternoon?
Well, we was going shopping.
Kettle's on. Tea, coffee or pot noodle?
Even better, because actually, my coffee afternoon was going to be in the nature of a product party.
A what?
It's a way of viewing and buying high-quality merchandise at wholesale prices in the comfort and privacy of your own home without any high-pressure salesmanship. Say you'll do it, you'll be saving my life.
I don't know.
So it's sort of like a Tupperware party then, eh?
I like to think it's a titch-up market from plastic boxes for leftovers, dear.
It's put me in my place, isn't it?
And Tracy, the party hostess gets a 15% commission and all she has to do is supply the nibbles and the drinkies. You could easily pick up 40 or 50 pounds, pin money.
Thank you, Dorian, but I don't need pin money.
Oh, I do. I'll be your hostess.
Thank you, dear, but I don't think my friends want to schlap out to a council flat in a tower block where the lift doesn't work and your cabriolet gets vandalised while you're still in it.
You've been telling her where I live?
Just a lucky guess.
Doing this. I don't want Tupperware. I don't need Tupperware. I don't even like Tupperware.
It ain't Tupperware, Trace.
What?
I've just seen that Dorian unpacking her gear. And no way is it Tupperware.
Oh, well, that's something. What is it then? Perfume? Jewellery?
Look.
I ain't got a, you know...
A crotch.
Who'd wear them?
Sure, I would. I thought it'd make Chris pay any attention. Mind you, he wouldn't notice me in bed if I had a picture of Gary Lineker tattooed on me bum.
Well, I just don't want this stuff in my ass.
Oh, they're nothing. Everything else in the front room needs batteries.
Where's Dorian? I'm going to tell her to sling her a rook. What the hell do you think
they're
you're
here.
Doing?
Action stations.
Oh, I am tempted. I really am. Just to see his face. Go on, what's the damage?
Damage? These are perfect goods.
No, I mean, how much does it cost?
£75.
Blimey.
You must have it. It's so you.
Nothing that costs
5 quid is so me.
It's money well spent, darling. It'll put the magic back in your marriage.
I don't think Paul Daniels could put the magic back into my marriage. Okay, what about you, Trace? You've got the figure for it. He said, knock your Daryl socks off if he come home and see you in this.
Our marriage doesn't need artificial aids, thank you very much.
I thought you said you'd been married for 14 years.
I have. Childhood sweethearts, they were. Met in Woodbury Down, comprehensive in detention. She's never been out with another bloke, let alone slept with one.
Do you mind, Murphy?
No, it's sweet. I was the same. I met my husband on a kibbutz when I was 18. We were engaged for 3 years and I was still a virgin when I got married.
Good for you.
It was only later I started going out with other men.
You mean you're two-timing?
Absolutely not. I'm utterly faithful to Luke.
Thought your old man's name was Marcus.
He is, but Marcus and I haven't had a physical relationship since October 1987. No, it was the stock market crash, you see, it rendered him impotent. And though the FT index has staged a remarkable upturn since then, Marcus hasn't.
So who's this Luke, then?
Sharon knows.
23. He's gorgeous, and he works for Lundquist Kitchens. We met when he came round to measure up, and boy, did he measure up.
I'm sorry, Dorian, but I think it's all disgusting. You put me into having this party, you bring round all these horrible smutty gadgets, and then you talk about knocking off other fellas.
All right, Tracy, don't be such a prude. Just because you've got a perfect marriage and a perfect husband and a perfect house, don't mean the rest of us poor also-rans can't have a bit of fun.
Thank you, Sharon. Though I rather resent being called an also-ran. Well, I'm sorry if you're offended by my presence, by my attempts to befriend you, to introduce you to my social circle, to ease your way into Chigwell's society. But if you are so morally far above us, then I shall pack up my harmless love toys and vanish from your life as suddenly as I entered it.
So say so.
What for?
Go on.
No, go on.
It was nice meeting you, Sharon. You might live in a slum, but you do have a certain grace.
All right, Dorian, I'm sorry. It's my fault. Sit down. I'm making a mountain out of a molehill.
She's got cream that does that.
I accept your apology, dear. Look, you must have something to please this incredible husband of yours. Not one of the battery-powered items, obviously. But how about a camisole?
No, he's got an umbrella. It's a joke! I know what a camisole is, all right?
Oh, it's gorgeous.
Thank you.
How much?
Have it on me, dear.
Then you can have it on Daryl.
Sharon. Now, come on, I've got to pay.
No, please, it's just a manufacturer's sample.
Oh, well, if you're sure, then.
Of course. So you owe me a favour.
So you're going to model it for us then, Trace?
Do you mind? This is for my Daryl's eyes only.
What's his eyes got to do with it?
Chris, careful!
You clock that white Zephyr?
Yeah, smart.
You're joking, aren't you?
No.
Wasn't it a white Zephyr that failed to stop in an accident in Bowes Park this morning? I think we'll have Chummy.
Trixie, dear, you know that favour you said you owed me?
No.
When I gave you the camisole.
So I showed you a favour, you said that...
Well, let's not split hairs. The thing is, Luke's got 2 tickets for Bros at Wembley tonight.
You're a bit old for pop concerts, aren't you?
You're as young as the man you feel, dear.
Oh, now, I like that. That is good, isn't it good?
Anyway, the thing is, I need an alibi to tell Marcus tomorrow, so do you mind if I say I went to the ballet with you?
Yeah, I don't mind as it happens.
I say you went to the ballet with me, if you want.
With respect, Sharon, it has to be a plausible alibi. Fate will lead you back
to me. Yeah?
Tracy Stubbs.
Yeah?
CID.
Can we have a quiet word?
Oh, my God. I knew it. I knew I should never let you talk me into it.
Me? What have I done?
It's only the old Bill, isn't it?
Old Bill who?
Lily Law, Dorian.
Bill? Lily? I'm completely confused.
What's she talked you into, love?
Don't say nothing without a brief, Trace.
Don't talk to me about sodding briefs. Look, it weren't my idea to have this stupid sex AIDS party. I've got nothing to hide.
So who tipped you off, eh? One of them mates of yours is a grass.
Look, there's nothing illegal about things that go bonk in the night, love. If I were you, I'd try marriage guidance first.
You mind? I've got a perfect marriage.
Ed?
I think I'd better be going.
Who are you?
Just a neighbour.
What about you?
I'm her sister.
Ah, so you're Sharon Theo Dollyplops.
yeah, all right. I've been married to him for 8 years and I can't still pronounce it. So what do you want, eh?
Look, there ain't been an accident, has there?
No, I wouldn't call it an accident.
What's happened?
Well, now, how can we put it, eh? Oh, I know. You want to stock up on these sex aids, love? Because you won't be having any nookie with your husband again this century.
Oh, well. Now to run the gauntlet of all them slags.
Oh, it can't be that bad.
You try living here.
No, thanks.
Exactly. Tell you, Trace, I don't think I can take much more of this.
You go, for the boys. He could be on remand for ages, but once he comes to trial and they get off...
Get off? Get off? Trace, the law found shooters in the car. There's no way they're going to get off. Oh, well. Keep smiling. Mwah.
Wash clean, even at low temperature.
It's all right, ladies. No need to change the subject on my account. I know who you're talking about.
Well, it ain't every day we get an armed robber on our floor, is it?
Yeah. You normally have to make do with drunks and wife beaters like your Alf.
Where's the money from all these raids? That's what I'd like to know. You don't fool us by walking around in all your cheap clothes from the market. The sum reckons you must be sitting on half a million.
And if I was, do you think I'd still be living in this carsy?
If you ask me, it's your fault your Chris turned to crime.
You what?
He gave me a lift home the night before he was nicked.
That was nice of him.
Yeah, he'd just got that new Ford Zephyr. Anyhow, we got talking...
Before or after?
And he was saying how you couldn't give him babies. And what a disgrace that is for a Greek Cypriot bloke. He was very upset.
And you comforted him?
Yeah, I tried to cheer him up.
Well, after you'd finished cheering him up, you left your knickers in the glove compartment.
And when stopped, could give no satisfactory explanation for the presence of sawn-off shotguns in the boot of the Ford Zephyr owned by Mr. The jury know who I mean. And finally, we have the matter of the large accumulator wager placed by Mr. Stubbs, co-defendant. A bare half an hour after the security van was raided outside Mothercare, Newport Pagnell. We have heard how banknotes stolen during this evil armed robbery were recovered from the turf accountant's office and subsequently were found to bear the fingerprints of the aforementioned individual of Greek Cypriot extraction. Now, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, as you retire to consider your verdict.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
Yes.
Is it the verdict of you all?
Yes.
How do you find the defendants, guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Oh, no.
Daryl Kevin Stubbs and Christopher Theodore.
Theo Dopolopodus, you stupid old fart.
You are in contempt of court.
Big deal. I'm down for a 10-stretch anyway, am I?
I sentence you both to serve 12 years imprisonment. Take them down.
A phrase they'll hear often in the almost exclusively homosexual atmosphere of your average top security prison.
Love you, Daryl.
Wait for me, Tracy. Wait for me and all, Sharon.
What? You must be bloody joking. Waited long enough.
Let us
see him, you callous sods.
Oh, sorry, madam, but the transport leaves for Funky Brixton in 5 minutes' time. You wouldn't want them to miss their tea, would you? It's spam this afternoon. Come to think of it, it's spam most afternoons. I tell you what, get yourselves round at the tradesman's entrance. Maybe you can give them a wave goodbye.
I don't know, Trace. Those Windsors are just slits, aren't they?
Oh, I'm sure I saw him waving.
Yeah, of course you did. Come on, let's go, eh?
What am I gonna do, Shell? I'm gutted. It's like being widowed. It was my whole life. I haven't let myself think about it till now. But what's Garth gonna do without a dad? And the ass. It'll be so big and empty. I don't even know how to change a plug.
I do.
I'm dreading it, Shell. I'm dreading going home on my own.
Look, if you like, I'll stay with you for a bit, eh? Till you're feeling yourself again. We'll just pop back to the tip and I'll excavate a few clothes, all right?
You don't want to come home with me. You've got your own life to lead, don't you?
True. I'd rather lead yours. Oh! Oh! What? I'll let me shoo, won't I? Oh,
come on.